Hi, it's me Tina Amir and welcome to my channel. So for today, we're going to learn about vocabs, but this time it is for kata kerja tak transitif. Last time we learned about kata kerja transitif. So this time it's about kata kerja tak transitif. But before I begin, for this video, I'm just going to use informal pronunciation. For those of you who's not clear yet what is informal pronunciation, please watch my number 53 video, which is about confusing pronunciation. So regarding today's vocab, which is about kata kerja tak transitif, for this one I'm gonna elaborate the meaning when we starting for the next chapter. So without further delay, let's start. Number one, bekerja. Bekerja, so bekerja is working, is a prefix be plus the root word kerja. Kerja is work. So, bekerja. R is hardly audible, okay? Bekerja. For example, how you gonna say this for speaking? You just say kerja kat ladang. Kerja kat ladang. Actually, bekerja, right? For working. But somehow, for speaking, we just shorten to kerja. So, it is understandable that this is a verb and it's not a noun. We shorten bekerja to kerja. Kat is to replace the word di, which means at. Ladang is plantation. So, kerja kat ladang. Number two, pulang. So, this is the root word, pulang. So, pulang is return. But the common use word is actually balik. Balik, which carry the same meaning. So, for example, you want to say you want to go back home or return home. Then you just say balik rumah. Balik rumah. Number three, duduk. Duduk. This is the root word which means sit. So duduk. For speaking, Malay has some types of sitting position. So we have like duduk bersimpuh. Bersimpuh. Duduk bersimpuh. Some people also say duduk simpuh. But normally people will say duduk bersimpuh as shown in the picture. Number four, terpegun, terpegun. So, prefix ter plus the root word pegun. Terpegun is actually like stunned or struck dumb. You know, like you are still in one position and like speechless. The root word pegun actually means still, or in another word, it is motionless. So, how we use this for speaking? We just say, aku terpegun. Aku terpegun. Aku is I. For this one, please watch my pronouns video. So you use the right pronouns. But I just give example. Aku terpegun. I'm stunned or I'm struck dumb. Number five, menjerit. Menjerit. So the prefix men plus the root word jerit. So menjerit means screaming and also shouting. So basically in English, screaming is without words and shouting is with words. So menjerit cover both of that. So the root word jerit means scream or shout. For example, for speaking, we normally say, this is the question form, kenapa menjerit? Kenapa menjerit? Some people also say, kenapa jerit? But most people prefer to use the word menjerit. Kenapa menjerit? Why screaming? Why shouting? Number six, tersenyum, tersenyum. Tersenyum is smile, prefix ter plus the root word senyum. So tersenyum, which means smile, and senyum is actually smile. So for example, for speaking, we have something we call senyum sinis. Means when you see somebody don't smile sincerely, then you say senyum sinis. So sinis is actually cynical, and senyum is smile. So cynical smile is senyum sinis. Number seven, melancung. Prefix me plus the root word lancung. So it become melancung. Melancung is traveling. The root word here is lancung, which means travel. So for example, you may say to people, hobi melancung. Like your hobby is traveling. Hobi melancung. And for your information, for this one, people don't really say lancung. It sounds weird to us. Even normally we like to use the root word. For this one, we like to use with the prefix me. So, melancung. Melancung. Number eight, datang. Datang is come. So I give example here. Dia datang. He or she, dia, datang is come. Dia datang. So datang is root word. Number 9, prefix ber plus the root word bincang. Bincang. So it become berbincang. Berbincang means discussing. So bincang is actually discuss. For example, for speaking you say boleh bincang. Boleh bincang. It basically means able to be discussed. So boleh bincang. Number 10, tiba. This is root word tiba, which means arrive. Arrive. And then we have another word when we repeat that tiba-tiba. Tiba-tiba actually means suddenly. Suddenly. So we have tiba and also tiba-tiba, both carry different meanings. Number 11, bekerja sama. Bekerja sama. The root word here actually kerja sama. So prefix ber plus the root word kerja sama. So it become bekerja sama, which actually means to cooperate. To cooperate. So kerja actually means work and sama is together. So to cooperate and kerja sama is a noun which means cooperation. Cooperation. And we like to say kerjasama penting. Kerjasama penting, which means it is important to cooperate. Kerjasama penting. So for this one, for speaking, even though we know bekerjasama actually the verb, but we say kerjasama. For speaking, that's how it is. Kerjasama here doesn't mean that it is noun, but it's actually verb. But our people just like to shorten it, even it's wrong for formal Malay. Number 12, tidur. Tidur. This is the root word. Tidur means sleep. When we speak, we like to say tidur lena. Tidur lena. It means sleep well. Sleep well. Number 13, prefix ber plus the root word sadur and suffixkan. So, bersadurkan. Bersadurkan, which means coating with metals. The root word sadur actually means coat with metal. And normally we like to say sadur emas. Sadur emas, which means to coat with the gold. Emas is gold. Sadur emas. Number 14, tinggal. Tinggal, actually the root word, the meaning is leave. And for speaking, we like to say tinggal kat kampung. Tinggal kat kampung. Tinggal live. Kat is to replace the word di, which means at. Kampung is village. But for speaking also, we like to say duduk kat kampung. Duduk actually means sit. But for speaking, we actually mean it is live, not sit. Okay? So tinggal kat kampung or duduk kat kampung. Number 15, prefix ber plus the root word buat. Buat. So, berbuat. Berbuat means doing something. The root word buat actually means do or make, but in this case it's do. So, berbuat, doing something. For speaking, we normally just say buat baik. Buat baik. Baik is good. So, do good. Number 16, prefix ber plus the root word bantal. Plus the suffixkan. So, berbantalkan. Bantal actually means pillow. And berbantalkan actually means using something as pillow. Actually, this is quite poetic. For speaking, we don't really say this. But I give example, berbantalkan lengan. So, you actually using your arms. Lengan is arms. To lay your head on it. So, berbantalkan lengan. Number 17, berseluar. So, prefix ber plus the root word seluar. Seluar means pants. So, berseluar actually you wearing the pants. For speaking, we normally say pakai seluar jeans. Wearing the jeans pants, if you direct translate. But for formal Malay, you just say berseluar jeans. Berseluar jeans. Number 18, berbaju. Berbaju, prefix ber plus the root word baju. Baju actually means like upper part of outfit. either blouse or shirt. But for Malay, it's not necessary because berbaju or baju sometimes means clothes in general. So I give example here. This is formal Malay example. Berbaju kurung. Berbaju kurung. So baju kurung is actually our national clothes. Kurung actually means like lock. If you add the prefix meng plus the root word kurung, then it become mengurung, which means lock up or lock. Basically, as you can see, berbaju kurung, wearing the baju kurung is very decent. It's very cover up. So that's why we call it baju kurung, because it's really mengurung you. Number 19, menginap. So prefix meng plus the root word inap. Inap means stay, and menginap means staying overnight. Staying overnight, menginap, menginap. And we have words we call inap desa. Inap desa, inap is stay. Desa is another word of kampung, which means village. And inap desa is actually homestay. But we don't like to say inap desa. We prefer to say homestay. Number 20, menguning. Menguning. Prefix meng plus the root word kuning. It becomes menguning. So menguning is actually turning to yellow, because kuning actually means yellow. When we say this, for example, I give phrase here, padi menguning. Padi menguning. Padi is paddy or padi. Menguning is turning to yellow. That's basically about menguning. Number 21, prefix me plus the root word nyanyi. So it become menyanyi. Menyanyi is singing and nyanyi is sing. I give example here, suka nyanyi. Suka nyanyi, which means like to sing. Suka is like, nyanyi is sing. So, suka nyanyi, menyanyi. I know it's difficult for those of you, but it's menyanyi. And then, nyanyi. Number 22, prefix men plus the root word darat. Prefix men plus the root word darat, which become mendarat. So, mendarat is actually landing and darat is actually land. Malay people prefer to use the word landing compared to mendarat. Number 23, prefix ter plus the root word menung. So it become termenung, termenung. So termenung is actually pensive. So menung actually means sung in thought, sung in thought. For speaking, we like to say suka termenung, suka termenung. Suka is like. Number 24, prefix ter plus the root word jatuh. So prefix ter plus the root word jatuh, which means fall. So terjatuh is actually accidentally fall. Fall is jatuh. So terjatuh. Number 25, prefix ter plus the root word lambat. So terlambat. Lambat actually means late. So terlambat is accidentally late. Number 26, prefix ber plus the root word keliaran. So it become berkeliaran, which means roaming. And the word liar means wide. So berkeliaran is roaming. Number 27, runtuh. Runtuh. This is the root word runtuh, which means collapse. For example, bangunan runtuh. So building collapse. Number 28, prefix ber plus the root word gurau. So gurau is joke. So bergurau is actually joking. And we like to say this, gurau je, which means just joking. So that bergurau for speaking we shorten to gurau. And je is actually shorten of sahaja. Then it become je. Number 29, bersolek, bersolek. So prefix ber plus the root word solek, which become bersolek, which means makeup, makeup. And solek is actually to beautify oneself, either to dress up or makeup. But honestly, people prefer to use the word makeup, not bersolek. Number 30, prefix me plus the root word lawan. So it become melawan. Lawan is actually means opponent or fight. And melawan is actually means fighting or go against. That's the meaning of melawan. Number 31, membiak. So prefix mem plus the root word biak, which become membiak, which means to reproduce or to breed. So we say membiak. Number 32, prefix me plus the root word leco. So it become meleco, meleco, which means burn or scald. And the root word here is leco, leco. Number 33, terkenal. Prefix ter plus the root word kenal. Kenal is actually means recognize or know. But terkenal means famous. Famous, okay? But normally people prefer to use the word famous more than terkenal. Number 34, prefix ter plus the root word sorok. It becomes tersorok. So sorok actually means hide. And tersorok actually means accidentally hide. And last one, number 35, prefix ber plus the root word kibar plus the suffix an. So it become berkibaran, which means waving. And the root word kibar actually means wave. So kibar bendera is how we say normally when we wave the flag. So bendera is flag. I guess that's all our lesson for now. Thank you very much. Make sure you revise the vocabs from Kata, Kerja, Transitif, and also from this one, Kata, Kerja, Tak Transitif, because next one will be very tricky part where we learn how to form sentences. I guess that's all from me. Thank you very much for watching, and if you like my video, please check out my Patreon page so that I can have more time to make more videos. For those of you who support me through this medium, thank you very much. I really appreciate that. And for those of you who's watching me right now, thank you very much. And till we meet again then. Bye.